Do you understand the importance of being able to communicate with other people that may have some positive experiences and or negative experiences? How many of you, because often people say, no, we're not interested, but how many of you are excited and thankful that someone mentioned this to you? Absolutely. That they took the risk of what you might have said. So we're going to hear a little bit about the evolution of network marketing. Get a lot of good data, statistics. Again, take notes so that when you are in conversation, you're able to talk about that with others. Do you know Cynthia? Have you ever been on her product calls on Wednesday?
Yes. Yeah. Seen her on YouTube.
We're going to invite Miss Cynthia up.
I'm here.
Oh, she just snuck right by me. She's getting all prepared. There's water outside the door. Hopefully, you guys can hang on until break. And if you're really, really thirsty, not give me a little nod, and I'll go get you a glass.
Yeah.
Well, good morning, TelexFREE! Young. And for those of you who don't know me, my name is Cynthia Sligh, and yes, I do spell my last name innocently. That's S as in Sam, L-I-G-H, no S-L-Y here. And I say that, you guys, because I just looked at the program, and someone had me down for training, and they had Cynthia Sligh, S-L-Y. No, say boo! About to rock this new comp plan. Are y'all excited about the new comp plan? How many people are fairly new to network marketing? Raise your hand. Wow, look at the room. You know, I met a guy last night, Stuart, who was blowing it up, you guys, TelexFree, and he told me, I couldn't believe it, because I've been in this industry for 19 years. He told me this was his first network marketing company. Oh my goodness, can you imagine this being your first network marketing company? It took me 19 years of buying TelexFree. So some of y'all may not know about network marketing. So we want to just real quick tell you some interesting things about network marketing, how it all evolved, and just so that you can have an idea about network marketing. So the name of this presentation is the who, what, where, and why of multi-level marketing. And so let's talk a little bit about the evolution of multi-level marketing. In 1860, you guys, this is when it all kind of started, where they had what they call traveling salespeople, right? I mean, they were also known as peddlers. And I tell you what, these two guys really put sales and building big organizations on the map. This guy named Henry Hines, anybody know what he was responsible for selling?
Ketchup.
Hines ketchup, right? And then there was a guy named Asa Candler, and he was going around and building huge sales organizations, and he had this little brown-looking syrup called Coca-Cola. Has anybody ever heard of it? And so that started in the 1860s, you guys. And these guys is what really put these products and services and built these big companies as we know them today. And then in 1890, you guys, a guy named David McConnell, he launched this California perfume company. And guess what? It had 117 different products, built a huge organization, and in 1937, they changed the name of that company to Avon. Anybody heard of that little small company? Right? A multi-billion dollar company. Then in 1931, Frank Stanley launched Stanley Home Products. Anybody heard of Stanley back in the day? Right? And then in 1940s, this was the first vitamin company called Nutrilite Food, and they are the ones who are responsible said, back in the 40s. So if you think that this stuff is all new, it's been going on for a while, right? And guess what? Them two college brothers came together and they said, you know what? We want to join this Nutribite company. And they started running with that company, selling vitamins. They stayed there for a while. And they said, guess what? Let's start our own company. And so Rich DeRoss and Jay Von Andel, they are the ones who started Amway. Anybody heard of that company? And later they acquired the Nutribite company. And guess what? They blew it up. People started jumping into this thing like crazy. It kind of reminds you of TelexFree. Yeah. You know how everybody is just jumping into TelexFree like crazy. But guess what? People started making money. People started really realizing their dreams and financial freedom. And so guess what? In 1975, the Federal Trade Commission stepped in and said, you know what, we're going to file a lawsuit against Amway. These people, they are building a scam. They're building a pyramid. These people are making money. They're happy. Uh-uh. We're going to put a stop to that, right? Does that sound familiar to anybody? But guess what? In 1979, Amway won. It's a business model that uses independent distributors with a multi-level commission payout plan to move products from production to the consumer. The distributors earn commissions not only for their own efforts, but also on the efforts of other distributors that they recruit into the business. Sound familiar?
Sound familiar.
Now listen, I love this slide. Write it down, you guys, because when I saw the new comp plan, I said, oh my goodness, I love it. Because I like what John Paul Getty said. He says, you know what? I would rather earn 1% of 100 people's effort.
We earn 1 to 3%.
Yes.
All right. Woo.
Awesome, awesome. And so if you understand, that's where I was going, Randy. Our compensation plan, you guys, this is huge. This is huge. So let's keep it moving. Let's talk about what multi-level marketing is not. It's not going to door to door. It's not beating your friends over the head with products or services they don't want. It's not convincing people to do something they don't want to do. It's not a get-rich-quick scheme. It's not a pyramid scheme. And let's talk about this dreaded pyramid, okay? You hear, oh, that's a pyramid scheme. So let's talk about, let's define what a pyramid scheme is. It's a non-sustainable business model that involves the exchange of money primarily for enrolling other people in the scheme. Do we have products in TelexFree?
Yes!
Awesome, awesome. So make a note of that. So when anybody come to you and say, you know what, that sounds like a pyramid, you say, no, this is a sustainable business model where we gather customers. Can you get excited?
Yes!
What are characteristics of a good multi-level marketing company? Timing in the company. Is this not perfect timing in TelexFree?
Yes.
Consumable, essential products. A comp plan that pays the part-timer. Yes. They have a system for success. Company management experience with integrity. What are some industries that have embraced this MLM business model? Colleges and universities, you guys, they are now starting to teach a course in network marketing. You can now okay? The wireless information technology era is embracing network marketing. Can I get an amen? Health and wellness is embracing this business model. Insurance is embracing this business model. Cosmetics is embracing this business model. So what are some of the pitfalls of multi-level marketing? A lot of times you start with your business with family and friends, which may cause friction and alienation. Has anybody experienced that? You need to have a strong backbone, you guys, because many people will tell you no. Didn't the lady tell you no, Pat? Tyler told you no several times, but guess what? You had a strong backbone, right? You need to continuously recruit new reps. You need to keep sponsoring to build your organization. There is a financial commitment, am I right?
Yes.
Absolutely. You need to discipline and motivation to get the job done without being easily distracted. Let me say that again. You need discipline and motivation to get the job done without being easily distracted. Okay, so these are some of the pitfalls. So why should you start a multi-level marketing business? You don't need no degree or experience required. Are y'all excited about that?
Yeah.
It's a turnkey system. There's so many tax advantages, you guys. There's no geographical limitations or restrictions. Oh my goodness, is TelexFREE not a global company?
Yeah.
Flexible hours, no marketing business plan required, no startup costs, no overhead. Now, I want you to look at your neighbor and say, residual income.
Residual income.
If you don't understand residual income, you need to understand it today. I'm telling you, the experienced, seasoned network marketers, when we saw the new comp plan changes, we started jumping up and down. Why? Because we understand residual income. We understand making money in our sleep. And so residual income is any payment system where you receive regular, ongoing payments as a result of a single sale. Can you get excited?
Yeah.
True residual income is made by having the leverage. Look at your neighbor and say leverage.
Leverage.
Of multiple hundreds of people working under you. Oh, that deserves a big round of applause.
Cynthia, I have a question.
What's the question, Mr. Crosby?
Can you go back to your slide?
Yes.
The last one?
Yes.
You forgot one important one.
What's that?
Most people never get a check. In this company, with the new comp plan, everyone gets paid weekly.
And this was typical the other network marketing companies. But you guys, this is why we are running to TelexFree in just droves. It's unheard of for everybody in in network marketing to get a check. But can you get excited? And if you're excited, I want y'all to stand on your feet. Because it's free. Yeah. 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 I'm going to have to put a disclaimer on this slide. Because of TelexFree, and that is exciting. Okay, who joins multi-level marketing companies? People with money and no time to enjoy it. People with time but no money. Stay-at-home moms, young adults, college students, retirees, disabled, people looking for a change, entrepreneurs, individuals looking for a tax shelter. So who do you know, you guys, that can fit into this category? That will be a great, great candidate for what we have here. Now look, I love this. Anybody know who this guy is?
Yeah.
Donald Trump. Let me tell you a quick little story. He was on like the Tonight Show or something, and David Letterman asked him, listen, Mr. Donald Trump, you are a billionaire. You have made millions. If you were ever in a position where you lost it all, what would be the first thing that you would do? And guess what the words out of his mouth were?
TelexFree.
Network marketing. And guess what, you guys? The crowd started booing. The crowd started booing. And let me tell you what he said. That's why I'm sitting up here and you're sitting down. But in TelexFree, you guys, everyone gets paid. Yeah. guys. That's the reason why the seasoned entrepreneurs and network marketers have been in this industry for years. Because we were looking for that big one. Because people have found that right network marketing company, and overnight they became millionaires. The right place, the right time, with the right company, with the right product will blow your income up. It will change.